everyone, and welcome to my channel Let's Spur Shivani. I am Shivani Saxena, and in today's video I am going to take you through how you can crack a group discussion in your first attempt. I have been a part of like 20-25 group discussions in my life for different purposes, placements, internships, councils and all that, and I've never really had a problem cracking group discussions. So let me share my tricks, the tricks that I follow in my personal life with you guys through this video. If you're coming here for the first time, then definitely like this video right away and subscribe to my channel, because you surely do not want to miss any of the videos that I post. So starting with the way in the GDs happen, there can be four kinds of group discussions. Firstly, what I call the open debate. So here a topic is given to you and in which you have to either take a stand for or against it. This is just like your any typical group discussion. There is a time frame to it. So for example, you can be given like 2 minutes to think on the topic, some 12 minutes to discuss, and then 3 minutes to wrap it up. The second type is what I call the role play. Here you are given a short case, like a snippet of the case, and you have to take some discussions. So I'll just tell you about one case that I got in one of the processes. So a cricket team was getting formed, and there were some 7 to 8 players that were on debate. So we had, each one of us got one player each, and we had to debate why our player should be the one who should be filling that last seat, which is left. So here, you are basically, acting as a manager of that player and defending him and ensuring that you secure a place for that player in the team. So there can be cases like this as well. A third kind of format is a case discussion, wherein slightly longer, let's say like up to 2 pages or 3 pages case is given to you. You have obviously a longer time frame to read it and then start your discussion. Here, the best tip would be to always debate upon by using data points that are given in the case. So let me tell you an example. I got a case on cricket, and I was totally unfamiliar with the kind of terms they were using in that case. At first I got scared, but then I thought that in case I have no idea what the case is talking about, all I can do is stick by the data that is given. So I fought my case on the basis of the data, and I was able to crack the group discussion. So whenever you get any case discussions, always quantify whatever you are saying, always support your stand with some data points. Also, I've seen that in few of the case discussions, at the end of the discussion, you have to present a PPT. So this can be either in as an individual contribution or as a team. So either way, this can be a case as well. And the fourth one is known as a chairman's GD. So this is very different compared to other GD formats that I've just talked. Here, what happens is you are given multiple caselets. So some 6 to 8 caselets are given to you, and you have to act as a chairman of the company and decide on those 8 different cases that are presented to you. So it checks both your leadership abilities, how bold you are, how assertive you can be. At the same time, you also have to have really good listening abilities, because the other group members might be the departmental heads of those 6 to 8 departments the caselets belong to, and you also have to take into account what each of these people have to say, and ultimately you have to announce your decisions like a chairman of the company. So this can also be the case. Now, coming to the kind of topics that are given on the for the group discussion, there can be basically 3 kinds of GD formats. One is based on your current affairs. So there can be topics like, will India be able to double the farmer's income by 2022? Or is this slowdown in the economy structural or temporary, or it will go away? Will India be able to sustain the ban that it has put on Chinese app? And things of this sort. The second kind of topic that can be given is specialization related. So for example, if you're a part of sales and marketing, you can be asked to speak on women in sales or surrogate marketing, moment marketing, something like that. For other specializations, there can be common topics as well. So, will MBA be overrated after COVID crisis? Again, a very, hot topic these days. Automation, e-commerce, conquering the brick and mortar stores and all that. So, about the topics, I'm planning to make another video. Make sure that you have subscribed to my channel, because when that video goes up, you will get an alert in your feed. The third type of topic I'm talking about is abstract. So these are very vague topics, and you can take them in any direction that you want. And it's a great chance for you to actually back these abstract topics with whatever you have been reading in the newspapers. So an example, if I were to give you ethics versus profit, what will you choose? Smart work or hard work? Every cloud has a silver lining. Sky is pink, orange is the new black, and so on. So these are the abstract topics. Now talking about what will you be judged on in case of group discussions. The most important being the number of entries that you are making and how impactful those entries are. A lot of people make this mistake that they make multiple entries in the entire discussion, like 7, 8, 9. That is not a good thing. In my opinion, 3 impactful entries are enough, and then after that you should just sit down quietly. The third metric is your listening abilities. Fourth is your body language and communication. The way you are sitting in that room matters a lot. Right from the moment you enter the room till you are sitting there, and again after the discussion when you are leaving, you are being judged. So don't be fidgety, just keep your hands on the table like this. Or if you're holding a pen, keep it stable. Do not keep it moving throughout. So all this is getting noticed. Also, the way in which you are flexible in listening to others' opinions is also judged, which is called as teamwork. And then there is another quality which can be judged, which is leadership. So if the people are digressing from the topic that you have to talk about, if you are moderating it, if you are bringing it right back to track, if there is a fish market that is being created, how impactful are you in steering the discussion towards the topic that is being given? All this is also observed. Now we'll talk about the phases of group discussion. So I've divided the entire GD into 3 phases, starting with the commencement. Firstly, you have to dress up properly. It might happen that GD happens at a very odd hour. It can be at 4 a.m. in the morning or at 12 in the midnight. You have to look energetic. You cannot be sleepy. Like, whatever it takes to get the sleep out of your face, do that. I used to carry like coffee mugs, so the ready to make coffee mugs of Nestle that come. If you are a fan of energy drinks like Red Bull and all, carry that. If you require your friends to pinch you or whatever, just do that. But look energetic when you're entering the room. Now, second important point, you should know where you have to sit. Getting confused there is not a good thing. Ask your placement cell beforehand where you are supposed to sit. So usually it happens in a semicircle kind of format. So make sure where you are sitting. Also, regarding the sitting, I'll say each person is given a number tag. So make sure your number tag is like pinned up on the pocket. For girls, you can just pin it on the collar or the border of the shirt itself if you do not have a pocket. Because they don't know your names. All they write your reviews or ranks or marks, whatever the scoring is on the basis of the tag that is there. So make sure that it is visible. Now, there is a myth that whoever is able to introduce the GD first gets some brownie points. Not true at all. You should speak whenever you are ready to speak. I have seen that people just jump in and start the discussion, and they have nothing really to add on to that. So what they do is, good evening, good morning everyone, the topic is this, and let's start by discussing about dash dash dash. That's not worth it. Unless you have your opinion to add to it, do not start the group discussion. Also, while you're giving like 2-3 minutes to think about the topic, what you should do is quickly make a PESTEL framework. PESTEL stands for political, economic, social, technological, environmental and legal. So if there is a topic that is given to you, you should be covering all these 6 angles. So let's say political angle is taken up by someone else, you can take the environmental angle maybe, and that is how you can keep yourself active in the discussion. Now suppose whatever topic that you have got is controversial in nature or in which you do not have a very clear opinion. So it's alright to take a middle ground and battle about the topic on the basis of data points or things that you know. Let me give an example. So let's say the topic is, will farmers' income be able to double up by 2022? Now what you can do is, you can say, I used to think before the COVID crisis happened that this is very much possible, till about some of the initiatives of government and the different private sector companies that you know about. And then say, looking at the present situation, since the expenditure on health and such infrastructure is on the rise and the companies are also struggling to keep up with their profits, I feel the picture looks a bit hazy. So in this way, you have not clearly said a yes or a no, but you have used the knowledge that you have towards guiding the discussion. If the topic is such that you do not know what it means. So what is a good idea is that you wait for someone else to start the discussion and then you take up points from what that person has said and make your own points now. So that is why I say listening is very important. If you do not know anything, you can rephrase the person who has just spoken and add your opinion to that. Now the second stage is what I call the journey. Now the introduction part is over and you are in the middle of the heated discussion. What should you be doing in this scenario? If I talk about the body language, you should keep nodding your head whenever someone else is speaking. Do not maintain eye contact with the panelist sitting there. So if you are talking, so usually the semi-circle kind of formation is done so that you are able to see each one's faces. So while you are speaking, if you are let's say sitting in the center, then while you are speaking, also look towards your right and also look towards your left. And do not look towards the panelist. That is a very important advice I have to give. Second thing is, in case you feel that there is a new point that is coming to your mind, you can spend some time making note of that. So it's alright if you're writing in the middle of the discussion. So how many entries you should be making? 3 is more than enough. 3 impactful ones. Make yourself heard. The duration should be like 1 minute if it is there. It's fine. And do not take unnecessary pauses. So let's say if you're about to say 2-3 points, and after 1 point, if you look down towards your notebook, that is the moment when somebody else can catch up and they can cut you off in the middle. So it's best that you keep a mental note of all those 3 points and do not take a pause. Now, another commonly asked doubt in case of babies is, how should you be addressing your fellow group members? Never take their names. What you can do is you can say, as my friend over here mentioned, adding to what my friend just said, this is a good practice. Do not take names because, let's say in worst case scenario, if the panelists sit down to remember how much marks to give to each one of you, they'll remember the name of the person whose name you took and not yours. So you do not want to give away brownie points to the person whose name you just took. Also, never use adjectives. For example, that is a very impressive point raised by my friend. Why use the word impressive? You are in a way admitting to the fact that your friend is capable of giving more impressive points than you yourself did. So do not use any adjectives. If the topic is your comfort zone, something that you have read about or practiced, do not dominate the group discussion. That's a very bad thing. And if there are girls with you in the group, which there will be, never ever cut a girl in the middle. I know in the world where we are fighting for equality and everything, in group discussions, it is not considered polite to cut a girl when she is trying to speak. Also, stay away from citing your personal experiences which no one can relate to. For example, some incident might have happened in your life which is in a way related to the group discussion topic. But if you say that and nobody is really able to, you know, support you or contradict you, then decision will not go further. So restrain from discussing personal incidents. And lastly, do not use any slangs or fillers. A lot of people use words like yeah, etc. As in, like when they're trying to fill the space, you know, as I've said earlier, or you know, slangs like I am gonna, I wanna, and all that, I gotta, ASAP. So don't use all these acronyms or slangs. Stick to the full forms. You have like 15 minutes to discuss, and always sound very professional. Do not use all these slangs. Now coming to the last stage, which I call the destination. Here, each one of you, or so there can be like two cases, either each one of you is asked to summarize whatever discussion has happened in like around a minute, or the person who didn't get a chance to speak in the GD is asked to summarize. Either way, give your best. In case you are someone who couldn't make an entry or like more than one entry, this is a golden opportunity for you. The panelists themselves want to hear from you your opinion. So whatever points you have written down, make sure you are able to deliver those points effectively. Also, sometimes it happens that instead of summarizing the discussion, let's say in the discussion, there were let's say 10 people, 7 were for the statement and 3 were against. And if you are someone who was against the decision, you cannot say that the group has decided against it, trying to in a way impose your viewpoint. So whatever it is, it has to be the collective will of the group. So discuss whatever has happened very objectively and giving a neutral view, and you can add your points to it before concluding the discussion. Now, a very important question. What if a fish market is created? How should you react? Firstly, if you are a part of the fish market, withdraw yourself completely. It's not a good idea. You should give like 2-3 attempts, and if the chaos still persists, you back out of it. Secondly, what you can do is you can gain some extra points by trying to moderate the discussion. You can tell the people, I think we are running short of time and we should get back to the topic. Or, now till now we have discussed only the problems, let's now work towards the solution, or things like that, and try to moderate the discussion towards the actual agenda that is given to you. So this will give you some extra points. Also, if it happens that the panelists have to intervene and quieten the room, then you get ready with your point. As soon as the room becomes quiet, you start to speak. How can you prepare for these group discussions? First thing, newspaper, as I've said that earlier, keep reading about industries, that will also help. Secondly, I say there are various sites. So one of them I'm just mentioning, it's called MBA Universe, and it keeps on updating the current affairs topic, which can be a prospective topic for the group discussion. So you can check these out. Also, on a personal level, I say, if you have come across any news, what you can do is, in your notes register, which I have asked you to make, what you can do is write the topic, pros, cons, and in like bullets, 2-3 bullets, keep noting whatever can be the pros and whatever can be the cons. Also, I used to maintain like a thin notebook or a diary with data points only. So there are some data points which you can use in your GD to start the discussion, or to throw in between. So keep these data points ready with you so that in case you have to quote any report or any research by any XYZ agency, you are ready to do that. Now another question which I am getting is, how will this group discussion happen virtually? So I think it is possible with lesser number of people, and it will happen in a very organized manner. So let's say if out of like 20 minutes discussion, first 5 minutes can be devoted to each one of you addressing as introduction to the topic. Second part can be an open debate, wherein again it will be moderated by the panelists or your placement cell, whatever the case is. So make sure you do not create any chaos, because digitally it is, you know, even more tough to moderate the discussion. And lastly, each one of you can be asked to say your concluding remarks. Now coming to the last part of the video, what to say when you are making an entry. So I'm going to share a list of statements that you should be using when you are trying to make an entry. And here they are. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. I hope this will really help you in boosting your current preparation for both summer and the final placements. If you found this video useful, then like this video, subscribe to my channel, and also share this video with your friends so that the maximum people benefit from it.